Okay, we're ready to start using Python notebooks. What I have done is I've created an icon on my desktop so that all I have to do is click that icon to get the notebook server going, which just popped up. Notice that there are a number of different notebooks that show up in what's called the IPython dashboard. And the one that we're going to look at in this video is the implementing a copy routine notebook, which is the second one. The first one actually provides a completed notebook for this exercise, and you may want to look at that when we're done. So let's open this one up. And the first thing you will want to do is copy this so that you don't overwrite the original contents. So go to File, make a copy, and now we're working with a copy of that file. So notice that here the name has changed to implementing a copy routine copy 0. All right, what do we have here? Well, I'm going to let you read the text. What's important here is that we have boxes that are text, and then we have boxes in which you can place code that you can actually execute. So this is the first box in which we can place executable Python code. The first thing I'm going to do is use a package called NumPy, which makes defining and operating with matrices particularly convenient. So I'm say import NumPy as np, and what that means we'll find out in a second. So that brings in a package that has a bunch of routines that make it easy to manipulate matrices and perform operations with matrices. The operation we're going to perform right now is the creation of a matrix. And for that, NumPy has a routine called matrix, where you give it the entries of the matrix that you would like to create. Okay. Now, what's going on here? NumPy has a routine called matrix. There may be other packages that also have routines called matrix. So to indicate that it's the matrix routine from the package NumPy that you want to use, you prepend the name matrix with np, because up here you said import NumPy as np. Okay, so the np here is going to indicate that it's the routine from NumPy that you want to use. That's to avoid something that's called namespace conflicts. And we also want a vector y. So we'll put y here, and we'll set the values of y to this. Now, to execute this box, what you do is you either go up here to cell and say run, or instead what I'm going to do is press down the shift key and hit the return button or the enter button. And bingo, what we get are vectors x and y. Now, what's happened here? We defined x to actually be a matrix, because when we program with NumPy, we're going to view vectors as special cases of matrices, namely matrices with only one column. Okay. The fact that we set that matrix to this right here meant that the first row only has one entry in it, and that entry is 1. The second row only has one entry in it, and that entry is 2, etc. And bingo, we have ourselves two vectors, x and y. Now, in Python, you can simply copy by saying y is equal to x, and that should copy x into y. And indeed, if we execute this box, we see that the contents of x have been assigned to the contents of y. The problem with using the assignment in that way is that if you now change a value of x, okay, what do we have here? X is a vector, it's a column vector, but we actually created it as a matrix, which means that to index in it, we have to give two values, the row index and the column index. The column index is always 0 because the vector only has one column. So this here is the component of x indexed by 1, and we're setting it equal to -999. If I execute this box, what we notice is that not only the value in x changes, but the corresponding value in y changes as well. And that's rather annoying. This is known as a shallow copy. What happened is that when we did this assignment of x to y, What it really did was it pointed y to the same values as that were stored in x, and therefore if you change a value in x, it changes it in y. So let's start over. Let's reset x and y to the original vectors. And one way to change the values of y but not have this shallow copy happen is to say for I in the range from 0 to 3, set y I comma 0, that's the ith component of the vector y, to x of I comma 0. And if you execute that, you see that the values of x one by one have been assigned to the corresponding values of y. Let's look at this a little bit more carefully. What it really says here is, for all indices I in the range from, so range of 3 is really the set from 0 to 3, not including 3, but including 0. For all I in that range, set the ith component of y to the ith component of x. And now what we see is if we change one of the values in x, that value does not change in y. So the components of x were actually literally copied into y, and now you can change values of x without being afraid of also changing the same values in y. Now we may want to copy vectors of arbitrary length, and it would be kind of annoying to have to write this kind of for loop every time you wanted to do that. So the way you get around that is to create a little routine that does the copy for you. So let's define a routine called copy. Input are the vectors x and y. What it does is it copies the contents of x into y. Now, you need to know how long the vectors x and y are. So we're going to extract the row and column size of the matrix x. Remember, x is a vector, but we were creating x actually as a special matrix with only one column. So we're going to extract the row and the column size of that matrix with the NumPy routine shape. And once we have that shape, then we're going to write a for loop that says for I in the range from 0 to m, not including m, set y of I comma 0 equal to x of I comma 0. Now, to make it so that your notebook knows about this routine, what you have to do is execute this. Oops, I made a mistake. There should have been a colon here. So I'll fix that, and then I execute that box again. And now if we say copy from x to y, what we see is the contents of x copied into the contents of y. If we now change some other component of x, what we notice is that that component is not changed in y. Later in the course, it will be convenient to have a much more general copy routine. What does this routine look like? It's considered good practice to only import those routines from a package that you actually need. So here, I'm only importing the routine matrix and shape from NumPy, because those are the only routines that I actually need. I then say, let's define the routine copy, and I give some comments that indicate what this routine is supposed to do. That's good programming habit. Now, this routine should only work if matrices are passed in. So the first thing I check is whether X is a matrix and whether Y is a matrix. And if it isn't, then I'll print out an error message. I then extract the row and column size of x and y, and I check whether one of those two sizes is equal to 1. This particular routine will work whether x is a row vector or a column vector. In other words, it will work whether x consists of one row in the matrix or one column in the matrix. For that to be true, it has to be the case that one of the two sizes is equal to 1. And that's what's checked here. And then finally, this routine can copy a row into a column into a row, etc. So what it does here is it checks whether one of the sizes is equal to 1. And which size is equal to 1 determines whether it's a row or a column, and then it checks whether the size of the vectors is the same, and then proceeds to actually copy the one vector into the other vector. The remainder of this notebook then demonstrates how that routine works, and you may want to just look through that on your own. Finally, I draw your attention to the very last part of this notebook, where we discuss how this copy routine that we just discussed is part of a package that we built for this course called LAF. So if you want to copy one vector to another vector, all you need to do is import LAF as LAF. Remember, that imports the package, and then if you prepend the name of a routine in that package with LAF, it will pick out that routine from that package. And now if you're given two different vectors, all you need to do to copy one into the other is to say laf.copy x to y.